The topic of my research is automatic genre identification, which means the identification of different text type, so basically stylistics. And by genre, we don't really mean the literary genre, but a very wide range of text types, from literature to forum comments and academic, legal, press and spoken text. It's an automatic identification, which means that we use the machine learning methods, so only statistics and no human evaluation. Genre identification is basically stylistics, and as it often said, that the style is the man himself, and it is a very, very human thing. And even for a human, it is not always clear what genre that piece of text belongs to. I'm quite sure that if we made identification task with humans, we wouldn't get 100% accuracy either. So it's a bit obscure thing for humans as well, and for computers it's even more complicated, because the style, the genre, let's say, it is coded in very different levels of the text, like vocabulary or syntax, linguistic structure, and even orthography, for example, or the use of punctuation marks. We got the lower result for the so-called personal text. Personal text type is forum comments and this kind of trash of the internet. It is hard to identify for the computer, because it is really varied with respect to topics and also with respect to style. The other text type, like academic or legal text, or the text of the press, has some specific topics, specific sentence structures, but personal text can be basically anything, and that was difficult for our system. Well, if the linguist wants to study some linguistic phenomenon, it can be relevant to know in which text type does this phenomenon occurs, or if it is more characteristic to spoken text than written text, or it is something genre specific. Sometimes they just want to study a specific genre, and then they need this specific corpus. For the corpus building, by controlling the sources, that, for example, if I want a corpus with the press text type, I could just collect text from these kind of websites. But if I use automatic methods, the advantage is that I can use a really wide range of sources, and I don't really have to control it. I don't have to exactly know the websites I collect text from, and I don't need to know the structure of it. For example, this site has the news and the comments, and they must be divided in different subcorpora, and this could be done automatically. If you use machine learning methods, then you need a lot of training data, but really, really a lot of training data. And for this research, we used a Hungarian corpus, a corpus of Hunklerin, and this corpus is already divided in these six different subcorpora, and that's what we use.